That's what you're videoing, the same as the telly now.
Let's call it now.
Wicked.
Oh, yeah.
Another ultimate comparison then with 47 years between the C-130 and the AE-400 Atlas, which has entered into service recently with Royal Air Force. The aircraft has a 37-ton
It's a jet.
Two more transport aircraft coming over now. One big, one small. The small ones, the BAE-146. That's going to be very familiar to the Royal Family because that is the aircraft that is used to transport senior members of the Royal Family all around the world.
Yes, we're seeing the C-17 Globemaster, long-range strategic heavy duty transport.
This is all in London today.
We should have went down the river.
And here comes the Sentinel, another surveillance aircraft.
Another of the Royal Air Force's ISTAR platforms, the Sentinel R1 is a long-range, wide-area surveillance aircraft, which is operated today by 5 Squadron based at Royal Air Force Wellington.
Those ones.
Clearly enjoying the spectacle going over the palace today, and this is the biggest of them all. Get ready for the Voyager. It is almost 200 feet long, almost 200 feet wide. It is the RAF's largest aircraft.
Our Voyager, operated by 10 and 101 Squadrons based at Royal Air Force Bryce Morton, was primarily used for both air-to-air refueling and strategic air transport. The aircraft is in constant operation.
That's the one with a thing on the top, look at it.
This one.
Talking commentary.
A few more of the big beasts to come. This is another surveillance aircraft that is still playing a big role, isn't it, in the skies over Syria and Iraq?
Yes, we're looking at the RC-135 joint, another one of the Royal Air Force's ISTAR aircraft. Operated this time by 50-watt.
Look at these bad boys. They're a bad boy. These gems.
Same coming.
And it's easily recognisable by the radar on its roof.
Behind the bigger joint is the AWACS E3D. That's the Airborne Warning Control System. The E3D Sentry is an airborne early warning aircraft with command and control capacity too.
And over it goes. Stand by now for the first of the fast jets. Here they come. These are the Hawk T1s. They're the type of aircraft used by the Red Arrows. There are going to be almost 60 fast jets passing over us in the next few minutes alone.
60
more coming up. These aircraft are supplied by 100. I'm sitting down. Give up. That 60 more. Are they main in groups?
Well, there's 10 in that, isn't there?
So they're 10 each time, so six sets of 10.
9 in there. Oh, look at it. Can't fuck with us.
And in the Diamond 9, these are Hawk 2s, which are more advanced. And these are used to train fighter pilots moving on to the next stage.
Exactly that. They're used for advanced fast jet training, the final stage of training before pilots reach operational aircraft. The aircraft has a glass cockpit, and that helps the pilots to transfer to our more modern frontline jets.
Red Arrows. Do your colours, boys.
Amazing sight, certainly this is the first time.
Look at them. It's got a 100, look.
They're driving in a 100, the ones that was in front. And they're at arrow. Look, they're at 100.
But they made an arrow shape, look at them.
Yeah, but the ones before made a 100. If you looked at it, it said 100.
I'll have a look in a minute. I haven't noticed before. But I think there's another piece coming up.
They're doing their arrows, look.
Look, oh, they've just done the smoke there, Sarah.
Missed it. I can't see that. There's one more left, I'm missing it.
Where?
I don't know, they said there was one more. Oh, is it them there?
Arrows,
I just missed
them. Yeah.
Well, just got
the smoke in the air.